Welcome back, everybody. Cody, Wyoming, have you heard of it? Has only about 10,000 people, but apparently it is full of personality. Here to give us a guide to the best of the West is our friend Adina Anderson. Adina, good morning.
Good morning. How are you today?
I'm doing great. I know that you're standing in a really cool location. Why don't you tell me where you are, and then we'll get into Cody.
Yes. So I am actually in Salt Lake City, Utah. This is the view from the Radisson Hotel downtown. I think you get this view pretty much from any hotel downtown here. It's so pretty. I mean, I have the Capitol. I have the mountains. I've got the train that goes by. It's kind of cool here.
Yeah, I sure think so. Okay. Cody, Wyoming, you've just finished a visit there. I do want to say our boss, his sister is the Postmaster General of Cody, Wyoming, which is the weirdest small world of anything. But let's you and I talk about your experience there. Yeah, why is it a great place to visit?
Well, first of all, Cody, Wyoming is my home away from home. I would stay there half the year and the other half in Texas. It is just beautiful. The people, the minute you get there, they make you feel like you have been there forever. And there's so much to do there. A lot of people go during the summer, you know, because it does snow and you can't get into certain parks. But in the fall, it's really the great time to go because there's still so much to do there. There's the Cody Cattle Company. It's a dinner and a show that goes on through September. There's fly fishing, which goes on through until the snow stops it. And then they actually kind of do a little fly fishing in the snow as well if you can get there. And they have the Cody firearms, which I got to shoot some pretty cool guns there that you can't shoot anywhere else. I shot some guns from World War I, World War II. Whoa. It's a really cool place to go if you like to do that. And then you can head out on a UTV and you pick it up in Meeteetse, which is just a little bit south of Cody. And you go into Kerwin Ghost Town, which is, it's a day trip and it is so much fun. And that's, I'm going to go back and do that one, I think, in October.
Just sounds good to me.
So much fun.
Yeah. Yes, okay. I'm seeing some snow on the tops of the hills and things like that.
Beartooth Pass.
Yeah.
Yeah. So if Beartooth Pass is open, you can definitely go still drive up there. But they do close it the minute that snow comes because, well, you see how high it is. I mean, that was now, you know, so it's going to get really high once it really starts snowing up there.
I'm going to have to tell you what we're seeing on our screens here, Adina. A bear, bison, question mark?
Oh my
gosh. So much wildlife. Talk to me about that.
Yes, definitely. So Cody, Wyoming is only about an hour and a half from the east entrance of Yellowstone National Park, which is my favorite national park. And we saw a grizzly. That bear was a grizzly bear. And I do want to talk about that. When you go into Cody, Wyoming, into Yellowstone, you make sure you have your bear spray. It is a must because you just never know. And this is great stuff. And the same thing when you go into Kerwin. But we saw bison, grizzly, elk, a fox. We saw moose. I mean, it is so much fun to go in there. Upper Falls and Lower Falls are two great places to visit. And then Grand Prismatic is amazing.
Okay, yeah, so different than Texas. Hard to even picture, but seeing a moose in real life would be amazing. Okay, places
to stay.
Talk to me about that.
Yes. Definitely. So the Chamberlain Inn is beautiful. They have cocktails every night. They have live music. It's a very boutique-y type of hotel, and Ernest Hemingway actually stayed there. They had the signature on the guest book, which is kind of cool. And then the Irma Hotel is the oldest hotel. It was created by Bill Cody and, you know, Buffalo Bill Cody, and it's named after his daughter, and it's very historic. It has a bar and grill in there. The food is phenomenal, and there's just a lot of restaurants there as well, and there's so many hotels. You know, you have your chain hotels, you have your boutique hotels. There's a lot to choose from there.
Sounds good. Okay, I know you're starting in Salt Lake City because you're about to do an 8-day trip with Southwest Adventures Tours. In the last 30 seconds or so that we've got, why don't you tell me about that?
Definitely. Southwest Adventure Tours has tours all over the Southwest, in Alaska, in Montana, everywhere. And their 8-day trip to Cody starts in Salt Lake City, goes to Jackson Hole, the Grand Tetons, which is amazing, into Yellowstone, and then back into Salt Lake City. And they drive you, they take care of hotel, everything. So they have a lot of different packages ranging in different prices. So definitely check out their website. There's so many different things to see.
Lovely. And in our last 10 seconds, you've got books coming up.
Yes. So my book is out, 100 Things to Do in San Antonio Before You Die. It's the third edition, and it is out. And we are going to start book signing next week. I co-wrote it with Jennifer Broom, a friend of mine. And it will be up on the website soon. And you can purchase it. Go into my website.
I'm so proud of you. Congratulations, y'all. Keep up with Adina and all of her tips at creativelifestyles.tv and keep up with all of her trips at travellifewithadina.com.